The Treaties tab provides more than 4,000 worldwide tax treaties translated into English. Treaties include U.S. treaties and country to country. Use the drop-down menus in the upper left to search for available treaty documents between two countries. From the drop-down menu, you can scroll through the list of countries to select one, or type it out at the top, like United States. Then select it and click Done. For the second country, I'll select Canada. If there is an active treaty between the two countries, it opens by default on the right. In this case, we see the active treaty between U.S. and Canada, which was amended most recently by the 2007 protocol. You can use the left navigation pane to navigate through the list of available treaty documents, including treaty history, with the most recent protocol listed first from 2007, which is currently displayed by default, and then prior protocol listed in reverse order, in this case, 1997, 1995, 1984, etc. If you continue to scroll down, you'll also see the original 1980 treaty document, along with individual protocol documents listed separately. We also provide technical explanations by year with the most recent first, as well as information on withholding tax rates and withholding tax forms. At the top of the left navigation pane, you can find treaty news for the two selected countries, with the most recent news listed first. Or review the treaty status between the two countries. In this example, the treaty status is active, and you can see the signed and effective date on the far right, as well as a list of all of the other treaties that the U.S. and Canada have entered into with other countries. Treaties become available in the software once it becomes effective. If you expand United States tax treaties with all other countries, it will list all of the treaties that the U.S. has entered into, including the status, like signed, active, terminated, or unperfected. You can also click on the treaty icon to view the treaty in English. On the left, treaty analysis is provided for 350 major treaties, including all of the U.S. treaties. Analysis is written exclusively by the experts at Orbitax and covers typical pain points you'll need to review in the treaty, so you can do a quick review here before having to dive into the full treaty. Towards the bottom of the left navigation pane, you can also find the tax information exchange agreements between the two countries, as well as the tax information exchange status between country 1 and country 2. Tax authorities globally are putting a greater emphasis on the exchange of tax information between countries, including several elements of the OECD BEPS project, like the exchange of country-by-country reporting information. Here you can easily see, is there a tax treaty? Yes. Is there a tax information exchange agreement? No. Has there been an exchange of country-by-country reports? In this case, no. You can click on the icon for more information. You can also view the active information exchange between the U.S. and other countries, and between Canada and other countries. Below the Tax Information Exchange section, you can find other tax treaty documents, like Orbitax Commentary, with tax treaty analysis and interpretation. This can be especially helpful in understanding the parts of the treaty that can be vague or even silent, like technical services. You can use the Table of Contents links on the right to jump to a specific section. For example, under Specific Treaty Provisions, you can find a helpful discussion on technical services under 6.3 Royalties. And scroll down to the discussion on Technical Assistance and Similar Services. Below the discussion, you'll find a visual flowchart on Payment for Services. On the left, if you scroll down below Other Tax Treaty Documents, you can find Social Security documents as long as one of the countries you selected is the U.S. For example, if you're looking for export information, you'll be able to find it in the Social Security Agreement.